Good afternoon, children. Welcome to class 7 chemistry IIT class. Today we are going to discuss about last chapter in chemistry, that is matter. What is matter? Okay, we are studying about this matter from the last 2 years also. From when you are from the 5th class, we are studying what is matter. Okay, so here matter is nothing but it is a substance which occupies some space. Okay, so even the gas also will be occupying some space. Okay, so what are the substances which occupy some space, it has some weight, then we can say it is a matter. We have different types of properties and we have different properties for the matter. Some matters are solids very hot, some matters are very soft which break easily. Okay, some matters are in the form of liquid, some matter is in the form of gaseous. Okay, and even some matters or some substance will be mixable in the water. Okay, some substance will be having capable to mix other substance into them. Okay, or the substance which is able to mix with other substance is called as soluble substance. For example, if you take water and salt, if you mix salt in the water, here water, salt is a soluble substance. Okay, so here some substance are soluble which will be mixing in the water. Some substances are insoluble which will not mix in the water. Sulfur does not mix in the water. So sulfur is a insoluble substance which will not solve, which will not dissolve in the water. And next is, if we take some dust, dust also will not be soluble in the water. So it is insoluble substance. Okay, so here matters can be solids, liquids, gaseous, soluble, insoluble, and even they may be good conductors or bad conductors of heat and electricity. For example, if you take wood, okay, it does not transmit heat very fast. Okay, if you take steel as well as wood, whereas steel transmits the heat very fast, wood does not transmit the heat very fast. That means here steel is a good conductor, it absorbs the heat very fast. It absorbs the heat, whereas wood does not absorb the heat as much as steel. So here wood is a bad conductor of heat and electricity, whereas steel is a good conductor of heat. Okay, in the same way we have lot of good conductors of heat as well as good conductors of electricity. Okay, conductors and insulators, which we have discussed in the electricity topic. Okay, based on all these characteristics, based on chemical characteristics, okay, whatever we have discussed, all is about the physical, how they look, soluble, insoluble, conductors, insulators. These are all the physical properties. When coming to the chemical properties, they have divided into two substances. In chemical properties, we have two physical characteristics as well as chemical characteristics. Physical characteristics is nothing but soluble, insoluble, conductors, and insulators. Chemical characteristics are nothing but they are few substances or mixture. So here matter consists of mainly, by seeing we can say that it is either solid, liquid or gaseous. That means the physical structure of the matter says it is either solid, liquid or gaseous. The chemical characteristics of the matter says either it is a pure substance or mixture. Pure means which is made up of only one element, one atom. Mixture which is made up of one or more atoms. Okay, so here matter is divided according to two characteristics. They are physical properties as well as physical characteristics and the chemical characteristics. So here physical properties are like just solids, liquids and gaseous. So we all know what are the properties of solids, liquids as well as gaseous. Solids, first thing we will discuss about solids. Properties of solids. These solids are very hard. Okay, we can touch them, they occupy some space, they are hard to break, whereas some are soft to break. We can hold them in your hand. It has definite shape, it has definite volume, it has some mass and weight. So here solids on heating will be expanding. On solids on heating, solids will be expanding. And why the solids are hard? Why? Because for example, if we consider this solid, it will be having the solid is this matter. The solids are some substances made up of, every substance is made up of matter, right? So here solid contains small atoms. Okay, any particle we take, it is made up of small atoms grouped together. See, here in solids the atoms are very close to each other. Okay, so the force of attraction between each atom is more. So in this way the atoms are very close to each other. Whereas in liquids, the atoms of the liquids are not very close as solids. Okay, that is the reason they do not have definite shape. Whereas gases, they will be having intermolecular surface very far from each other. Okay, so solids will be having intermolecular forces very more. They will be combined to each other. That is the reason they are very hard. Whereas liquids, the intermolecular force is less when compared to solid. So they does not have any shape, but it has weight and volume. Even gases do not have any shape, and they will be occupying some space. We cannot see that. Solids and liquids we can see it, whereas gases we cannot see with our eye. Okay. So solids will be having more amount of atoms which are very closely packed to each other. Liquids will be having atoms which are loosely packed, whereas gases will be having atoms which are packed very very loosely. Okay, that means there the force is less and more space is available in the gaseous. And some space is available in the liquids and more space is available in the solids. So this is regarding solids, liquids and gaseous. Okay, and next one more thing. If two solids are kept together, then there will not be any diffusion. That means one solid will not go to other subsolid to mix. Whereas in liquids, if you keep them in one container, two liquids, there is a chance to diffuse. Okay, whereas gaseous, they diffuse very easily. Okay, gaseous, as the space is more, if you kept two gases together, then they can be easily mixed. Whereas in liquids, it needs some time. Okay, that means as they both are, they will be having some intermolecular, there is some distance in between two atoms, there is a chance to diffuse. But in solids, two substances if they are kept together, there will not be any diffusion. Okay, so this is regarding solids, liquids as well as gaseous. So here solids will be having definite shape, definite volume, size. Whereas liquids does not have definite shape and size, but it just occupies the shape of the container. Solids cannot diffuse. Okay. Whereas liquid can diffuse based on the situation of the molecules, that is characteristics of the molecules. Why? Because as the space is more, there is a chance to diffuse. Whereas gases does not have any shape. Okay, we cannot touch it, but we can feel it, and here as there is more amount of space, they can diffuse easily. They are hard, they are less hard, not so hard as solids. They are very loosely packed. This is regarding solids, liquids as well as gases. Can we change solids to liquids, liquids to gaseous, gaseous to again liquids? We can change. We have learned in the water cycle, no? Number of times we have discussed about water cycle. How we can change solid to liquid? For example, I am taking a water here. Okay. What happens? So this water is formed, liquid form. Okay. Now if I want to change this liquid into gas, so what I have to do? I have to heat it. Yes, if I produce heat, then I can make this water into water vapor. That is a gaseous form. Clear? Now this water I have to make into solid form. What I have to do? I want ice. By heating I have obtained gas, no? So if I want to obtain ice, what I have to do? I have to take out heat. That means I have to freeze it. That means by heating, liquid changes to gaseous. By cooling, that means by freezing, water liquid changes into solids form. Clear? So here water changes to water vapor. That process is called as evaporation. Okay. Now water vapor changing to water, it is called as what? Water vapor to water. How to change water vapor to water? Again condensation, right? From gaseous to liquid. So there it can be changed into condensation. Now can I change ice solids into directly gases? Can I change solids to directly gases? We can change some substance directly from solids to gaseous without forming the liquid here. So that type of substance, that process is called as sublimation by heating. We have discussed about sublimation also. So for example, if you take camphor, we all know camphor or naphthalene balls. Okay, if we heat it, if you heat them, what happens? Or I simply heat it out in the summer season. Morning you keep it warm. Proper naphthalene ball or camphor outside, see in the evening. The amount of the size of the camphor or naphthalene will be decreased. That means without changing into liquids, it is evaporated due to heat. Like that substance, such type of substance are called, such type of change is called as sublimation, and the substance which is forming into vapor, they are called as sublime. So here, to take sublimation process, take a china dish, okay, heat it, now put a camphor in it and put a glass plate on it. So once it started heating, you will be seeing some flames going and touching the lid. Okay, once it touches the lid, after some time you can see a small powder like substance which is attached to the glass. That means due to heat, the solid is actually changing into what? Vapor, without forming any liquid. Again, due to this vapor, when it is heated, if it after cooling, it forms into solid again. Sublimation is a process in which solids directly change into gases, and on cooling, gases directly change into solids. So this is how sublimation is done. And evaporation is nothing but the change of solids to liquid is called as solids to liquids is called as evaporation. Okay. Liquids to gases. The change of liquids to gases is called as evaporation, and the change of gases to liquid is called as condensation, which we have discussed in the water cycle. Water cycle is a continuous process of evaporation as well as condensation. Water vapor, change of liquids to gases. Condensation, change of gases to liquid. Okay, next is how to change this solid into liquid. So here if you take ice, if you want to make it to water, for some time we have to heat it. Okay. So there directly if we start heating, it will not be changing into water. It takes some time. Why it takes some time? Okay. That means the ice needs some temperature to start melting. Okay. Not boiling or becoming totally water. Just at some temperature, the ice starts releasing water. That means it will be emitting the water outside. Okay, it will be changing into water. That point, at what temperature the ice changes into, that means the solid changes into liquid, it is called as melting point. Okay, and once all the solid melts, it starts boiling. Okay, here also it takes some time. That means there it takes some temperature to increase. As the temperature increases, here the solid, the liquid will be changing into gaseous form. That is, it starts boiling. Okay, the point at which the water starts or the liquid starts boiling is called as boiling point of the liquid. For example, the melting point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. At 0 degrees Celsius, the ice starts melting. Okay, if you heat the ice at 0 degrees Celsius, it starts melting. Whereas, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Once the water reaches 100 degrees Celsius, it starts boiling, that is evaporating. This is regarding melting point as well as boiling point as well as evaporation, condensation, sublimation. Okay, next is there any use of states of matter? By changing this substance, is there any use?
We have lot of uses by change of these states of matter.
Okay. Due to this change of states of matter, we are getting proper rains. Yes. So if there is no change of states of matter, no proper rains or no rains at all, and water will be decreasing in the on the. So here this change of what was it? Change of matter is compulsory. We have lot of uses due to this change of states of matter. So what is the main use? On heating solids. On heating solids, what we can do? I have said that solids expand on heating. Okay, so we are getting different types of metal objects, windows, all those things, tables. How they are obtained? We are getting different. And it is made up of glass. How the shapes are molded? For example, if you take a rock, if you want to take any shape, we can have to beat it with the hammer and the nail. So we'll get the option. The proper shape of the stone. Then how to get it from the glass? It is just because of heating. On heating, solids will be expanding. When they expand, the force between intermolecular attraction decreases. At that time, we can make them into different shape. Did you observe any time glass making? How the glass bubbles are making? How plastic is made? How plastic substance can be expanded? On heating, plastic substance can be expanded. And after expanding, when they cools again, they get to their original position. Okay, that means on heating solids expand. By heating these solids, we have obtained lot of materials, lot of different shapes. Okay, on heating liquids, we are getting water. That means water is evaporated. So here there are lot of reasons for the changes of states of matter. By liquidifying air, that means by separating of hydrogen and oxygen, we are able to give ready-made oxygen for the patients. They will keep oxygen mask on. That means they will be producing oxygen for the patients. Even for the mountaineers also, they will be carrying oxygen cylinders with them, which is filled with only oxygen. How we are able to separate this oxygen? With the help of changes of states of matter. Okay, so here by liquidification air, that means we can change the gas into liquid air. Okay, so we are collecting all the oxygen in one place. Even gases also we can separate. So this is regarding the physical characteristics. Coming to chemical characteristics, we have mainly two types: pure substance as well as mixture or compound. We can say it as mixture or compound. Again, pure substance is nothing but the substance which is made up of only one kind of atom. Okay, so here any substance we can take that should be made by only one type of atom. If you take plastic bottle, only one type of plastic or one type of atom is used in that. It is only plastic atom, right? So in such way we have different atoms. Whereas some gold ornaments, only some which are made with pure gold. Okay. So if they are made with pure gold, or diamond is also made up of only one atom, it is carbon atom. Okay. So diamond is also made up of only one atom. So the substance which are made with only one atom, they are called as pure substance. Okay. So again, in these pure substances, we have three types. They are monatomic element, diatomic, and next is polyatomic. So here polyatomic elements are nothing but regarding the pure substances and mixtures, we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.